Hi friends, I am B. Ramesh, St. Peter's Engineering College. Today I am going to explain you analog electronics and digital electronics, which is for computer science, engineering and information technology student, second year, RIT regulation, second year, first semester. Okay. So first topic subject is analog and digital electronics, short form we can call ADE, analog and digital electronics. So first, what is analog electronics and what is digital electronics? Analog electronics and digital electronics. Simple word you can remember, analog electronics means by applying continuous signal, if you study the movement of charge carriers in an electronic device, that is called analog electronics. And similarly, if you apply the digital electronics definition, you can remember easy way, by applying high and low voltage, that is called, if you see the movement of charge carriers in a digital circuit, digital devices, we can call digital electronics. Okay, so if you see the analog electronics, the first analog electronics and remaining 2.5 unit digital electronics. So first unit in analog electronics, diode and applications. Okay, so diode and applications. So before going to this first unit topic, we must know the basic concept of electronics. Okay, so that will I will cover in this session, the basics of analog electronics. Okay, so that will I will explain you now. So first, before going to this unit, first I would like to explain you about why we are approaching the electronic devices to make the equipment, to make the any device circuit. Okay, so the first we would like to know about electrical elements classifications, three types: conductors, semiconductors and insulators. So electrical elements, our universal is depends on the electrical elements. Okay, so three types electrical elements, one is conductor, semiconductor, insulator. So conductor, the example of conductor materials: copper, aluminium, gold, okay, iron. So these are the example of conductor material. And semiconductor, silicon, germanium, okay, arsenic phosphate, okay, and etc. The next one, insulator: wood, glass, paper, which does not allow the electricity, that is called that material, that elements are wood, suppose glass, paper, which having the more than 4 valency electrons, that is called insulator. Okay, and so how we suppose identify the particular element is belongs to a particular category? So based on the valency electrons. So first one, if valency electrons less than 4, valence electrons less than 4, so that is called a conductor material. If valence electrons exactly 4, that is called a semiconductor material. Okay, if greater than 4 valence electrons contains the element, that is called a insulator. Okay, so the next point, how to suppose fill the electrons in a each and every orbit means based on the 2n square principle. I will explain you by taking any one element so that you can easy to identify, easy to fill the electrons in each and every orbit. Okay, so first orbit 2 electrons, and second orbit 8 electrons, third orbit 18 electrons the capability. Okay, so here conductors are good conductors, okay, and semiconductor having the resistivity greater than the conductor and less than the insulator. Okay, the conductivity, the resistance ideally we can say zero. Okay, and here not more than the suppose insulator, greater than the suppose a medium, suppose a resistivity there for suppose 10 power of minus 4 to 10 power of plus 4 mho s by m sigma, and insulator we can say infinity resistance. Okay, that's why there is no current allows in insulator. Okay, then next one, the Faraday gap between valence band and conduction band and valence band is zero. Faraday gap, or suppose you can say energy gap zero for a conductor, and here the Faraday gap, that is for depends on the material. Okay, so this one is the valence band and this one is the conduction band. The energy gap is based on the material, and with respect to temperature, the Faraday gap will be increases and decreases. Okay, temperature increases, the gap will be decrease. If temperature decreases, gap is more between the valence band and conduction band. Okay, so for suppose silicon at 0 degrees, it has the energy gap 1.21 electrons. If 300 Kelvin or suppose 27 room temperature, at room temperature it has the valence band 1.1 electrovolts. This is for silicon. Okay, if it is germanium, the valence energy gap 0.72 electrovolts at room 0 degrees, and so suppose at room temperature it has the energy gap 0.7 electrovolts. Okay, if temperature increases, energy gap decreases. If temperature increases, energy gap decreases. Okay, there is a large energy gap between valence band and conduction band, larger gap, so greater than 15 electrovolts, energy gap between valence band and conduction band in insulator. That's why the conduction not takes place in that device materials. Okay, so these are the main points, and see why we are going for suppose electronic devices means here conductor materials are cost. There are two reasons. Okay, so compared to conductor and semiconductor, conductors materials are cost more, and there is no cutting voltage, no threshold voltage or cutting voltage. Okay, so when you see the semiconductor material, silicon having most cheapest material. Silicon is the most cheapest material. Excuse me. silicon is the most cheapest material. So this silicon made with sand. Sand is most cheapest material in universal. So that's why, and remaining components, remaining devices is also very cheapest compared to the conductor materials. That's why we are seeing the conduction. We are seeing the conductivity in semiconductor devices. First one is cheapest material, okay, and that provides the good result. Okay, compared to conductor, semiconductor, these are the generally the most of the people they refer to cost low and the profit should be high. So generally we are choosing that that product only. Okay, so for that reason only we are moving to the semiconductor materials. Okay, so if you see the semiconductor material, the structure, and if you see the semiconductor classifications, okay, so next just note down this one and you can make it copy. So these are the very very important points. Okay, you can note down this one. Yeah, okay. Insulators does not allow the electricity and their Faraday gap is very high. Okay, and that's why we are not choosing this materials for conduction purpose. Okay, that is the drawback in insulator. And here the drawback is in conductor, drawback is cost more and there is no cutting voltage. Okay, because our electronic equipments run with very low voltages. Very low voltages electronic equipment will be run. So we have to oppose the high voltage. Okay, we have to oppose the high voltage. So the cutting voltage must be required. Okay, right. Now see the semiconductor classification. Semiconductor classification. Semiconductor classifications two types. One is intrinsic semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductor, next one is the extrinsic semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductor and extrinsic semiconductor. So intrinsic semiconductor is nothing but the number of holes not equal to number of intrinsic semiconductor number of holes is equal to number of electrons, and extrinsic semiconductor number of holes not equal to number of electrons. Okay, so see here in this intrinsic semiconductor number of holes is equal to number of electrons. See, if you apply the if you see the conductivity in intrinsic semiconductor is less because number of holes is equal to number of electrons. Okay, so we have to increase the conductivity. So we have to increase the conductivity means we have to do the doping. Okay, so doping means add the impurities. Okay, that is called doping. Process of adding impurity is called doping. Okay, so why we need to add the doping means to improve the conductivity of particular material, we have to add the impurities. Okay, so how we are adding the impurities means,
If you add the trivalent impurities to the pure semiconductor or intrinsic semiconductor, that is called a p-type material. That is called a p-type material. Then next, if you add the pentavalent impurities to the pure semiconductor, that is called a n-type material. So how we are adding the trivalent impurities and pentavalent impurities to pure semiconductor, that we'll see now. Okay, so after adding this two, it becomes the eccentric semiconductor. Okay, so now I'm going to add trivalent impurities to pure semiconductor. Before that, I would like to explain you atomic structure of a particular element. Suppose if you see the silicon, the atomic number is 14. Atomic number is 14. So see the structure of this silicon element. Okay, silicon material. Okay, so the first orbit contains the 2 electrons. So how we are supposed to fill in this electrons means based on 2 n square principle. So first orbit means 2 into 1 square 2. So 2 electrons we can able to fill in this atom. Okay, first orbit 2 electrons, and second orbit 2 into 2 square 8 electrons. Second orbit capability is 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. And fourth orbit, third orbit, so 1, 2, 3. Okay. So fourth orbit, the capability is 18, but 2, 8, 10, and more we need, four electrons. So 4 electrons. So these 4 electrons are valency electrons. So 4 valency electrons. So which type of material we can say this one means semiconductor material, because it has 4 valency electrons. 4 valency electrons it has. Okay, then similarly if you see the atomic structure of germanium, so the atomic number is 34. Okay, so 34 means it has 4 valency electrons. Okay, you can verify, right? Apply the draw the atomic structure and you can verify the germanium material is whether belongs to conductor category or semiconductor or insulator. Okay, so this is the semiconductor material. Okay, germanium. Now we have to do the doping. So how we are supposed to adding the trivalent impurities to p-type semiconductor and p-type material, and how we are adding trivalent impurities to pure semiconductor and pentavalent impurities to the pure semiconductor. Okay, so now see the if we add the trivalent impurities to pure semiconductor, means which material having the 3 valency electrons, so conductor, we must do the doping with conductor to semiconductor, pure semiconductor, so that I will get the eccentric semiconductor. Okay, so if you see the boron is the conductor material. Okay, so atomic structure of boron, so first orbit 2 and the second orbit second orbit 3. Okay, so total
So three valence electrons belongs to the suppose conductor material. So boron having suppose three valence electrons. Okay, we have to do the doping with semiconductor, pure semiconductor. Pure semiconductor having valence electrons 4. Semiconductor having the valence electrons 4. Semiconductor having valence electron 4. Okay. So now the sharing of electrons that is become a covalent bond. The sharing of electron that becomes the covalent bond. But here there is no electron. Okay. So no electron means what will there here? Hole will be there here. Hole will be there. So this one we can say it is the acceptor ions with the excess hole. Okay. So this one is always try to become the covalent bond. Okay. So that's why we are saying this one is the acceptor ion. Okay. This is the one process. Okay. So in that process we are getting one extra free charge carriers. That one is the hole. Okay. So if you do the another process, for suppose taking same material, if you do the another process, silicon. So it has three valence electrons and conductor semiconductor having the four valence electrons. But here there is no electron. So again we are getting the here hole. Okay. So like the if you see the in that doping process, what we are getting means a free charge carrier hole. Okay, that's why we are saying this one is the p type of semiconductor material, p type of eccentric semiconductor we can say. So here the holes not equal to electrons. Okay, only so the doping process, if you see the 1:10^9 for a lightly doped diode, okay, and 1:10^6 for a Jenner diode process, the doping level 1:10^3 for a tunnel diode. Okay, so among this Jenner this tunnel diode is a very heavily doped diode. Okay, so lightly doped diode, by using this lightly doping we can make the PN junction diode. Okay, so like this we can add trivalent impurities to pure semiconductor, so that we will get the P type of semiconductor. You can note down this, you can copy from the board. Okay, so this is the process here. This is a process 1:10^9. That means we are adding impurity 1:10^9 semiconductor to one, we are adding one impurity. That's why we are saying this is a lightly doped diode. And here Jenner diode 1:10^6 semiconductor. Okay, we are adding one doping. And here also 1:10^3 we are adding one doping. Okay, so tunnel diode is a heavily doped diode. Okay, this is a process. Next one, if you see the pentavalent impurities, how we are supposed to adding the pentavalent impurities. Okay, so that becomes the n-type of material. n-type of semiconductor. So if you take nitrogen, atomic number is 7. Okay, first orbit 2, second orbit 5 valence electrons will be there. So more than 4, means that is becomes to belongs to suppose insulator category. So if you take the nitrogen, okay, so it has 5 valence electrons. It has the 5 valence electrons and one more electrons here suppose. Okay. So now the sharing of electrons, it becomes a covalent bond. All four actually a nitrogen having 5 valency electrons. Okay. The sharing of semiconductor, 4 electrons, and it becomes the covalent bond. Covalent bond. Covalent bond. Okay. So here one extra electrons suppose will be there. So we can say this one is a donor ion. Donor ion. We can say this one is a donor ion. Always it is ready to donate the electrons and try to become the covalent bond. Try to become the covalent bond. Okay. And here also it becomes the covalent bond. And one extra electrons will be there. So this is also donor ion. We can say with representing positive. Okay. So the donor ion. So in this process we are getting two extra two free charge carriers, that is electrons. Okay. So this kind of extra electrons, that material we are calling n-type material. Okay. So in this process free charge carriers are majority, we can say the electrons. Now if you see the structures of you can note down this one, you can note down the process how we are suppose adding impurities, pentavalent impurity. If you, we are adding pentavalent, see 1 2 1 2 3 4 5 pentavalent impurities to pure semiconductor. Pure semiconductor, that is called n-type material. Okay. Right. See the p-type material structure. N-type material structure. Okay. So p-type material, what are the majority carriers? Holes. Okay. So you can write like this. What is this? This is the holes and minority carriers electrons. So this one you can say acceptor ion with excess hole, and here you can say n-type material, donor ions with excess electrons and minority carriers holes. Minority carriers holes and here minority carriers electrons. In p-type material, minority carriers electrons, and n-type material minority carriers holes. P-type material majority carriers electrons, and n-type material majority carriers electrons, and p-type material majority carriers holes. Okay. What is the charge of hole? The hole charge is positive. Okay. And the electron charge is negative. Remember. Okay. Right. This is the structure of n-type and p-type material. So if you have a suppose idea about these two, we can able to make the diode. Okay. So what is the Fermi level? Fermi level in a p-type material. Okay. Remember, very very important. The Fermi level. Fermi level in p-type material below the valency band. Below the (coughs) valency band, below the valency band. And here level is Fermi level above conduction band,
because electrons already electrons there in conduction band only. Okay, that's why the Fermi level below the above the conduction band, and Fermi level in a hole below the valency band. Remember, okay. If you have any doubts till now, you can make the comment. I will clarify your doubts. Thank you.